For the recommendations of thematic group 3, which focused on the issue of environmental education and capacity building, I would like to invite the Honorable Justice Mr. Khilji Aarif Hussain, Judge, Supreme Court of Pakistan.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Nehmadu wa salli ala Rasul al-Karim. Honorable Chief Justice of Pakistan, Honorable Senior Appointed Judge, Honorable Anwar Zahid Jamali, Honorable Judges of the Supreme Court, High Court of Azad Jammu and Kashmir, Federal Shariat Court and abroad, Mr. Anwarul Haq, Attorney General of Pakistan, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum and good morning. I am greatly honored by the invitation extended to me on this useful 2 days conference on South Asia Conference on Environmental Justice. I sincerely hope that all of you would find this conference to be very useful for curbing the environmental issues that has been badly affecting our futures. Pakistan Environmental Act 1997 defined environment as air, water, land, and all layer of the atmosphere, all organic and inorganic matters, all social and economic condition affecting community life. The environment covers everything we do and encounter, not confined to only trees and park. What need is that first we educate ourselves in basic concept that how badly violation of fundamental rules of environments affect our life, who matter in policy making to take a step necessary for protecting the environment so that our coming generation can enjoy fresh air and water. To achieve a good quality of life on earth for all living beings, it is essential to spread awareness about the education humankind in sustainable development and environmental problems. And in this regard, teacher can play a pivotal role in transmitting knowledge and creating awareness about today's burning issues of dirty environment and help tackling it. Education and public awareness play a pivotal role in abating environmental problems. It is necessary that the basic concept of how to protect environment should be made part of the school system. As human beings continue to have significant impact on the environment and its resources, education seems to be the best tool for providing the public with an understanding for the repercussions of their actions, behaviors, patterns in order to increase sensitivity and concern surrounding environmental issues. The environmental education is a process that provides learners with awareness and knowledge about the environment and fosters the development of skill, attitude, and motivate to enable learners to make informed decisions, take reasonable actions that incorporate environmental consideration. The ultimate goal or outcome of the environmental education is the creation of environmental literate citizens. In the thematic sessions which I chaired along with Honorable Chief Justice of Balochistan Qazi Faizistan, valuable speakers were presented their papers. One of them was Mr. Justice Qazi Faizistan, Chief Justice of High Court of Balochistan, Honorable Justice Mansoor Ali Shah, Judge Lower High Court, Honorable Justice Taqdeer Rahmdi, Judge Supreme Court of Indonesia, Honorable Justice Hassan Firuz Siddiqui, Judge Supreme Court of Bangladesh, Honorable Justice Tahir Ali Ansari, Judge Supreme Court of Nepal, Honorable Justice Retired Tanveer Ahmed Khan, Director General Punjab Judicial Academy, Mr. Javed Jabbar, Vice President IUCN, and Ms. Huma Ikramullah, Faculty Member of the Sindh Judicial Academy. Justice Qadi Faizi sir speak about how religion can play important roles in protecting environment, important of nexus between the environment and Islam, and highlighted the fact that not only the Islam, but all the religion emphasizes on the importance of the protection of environment. Mr. Justice Mansoor Ali Shah, Judge Lahore High Court, provided a design course on the environmental law, touching on the principle of concept, historical evolutions, law, science, and specific area like biodiversity, waters, etc. He stressed the fact that there needs to be project-based training, which include field training so that the judges know what exactly is happening on the site and are able to understand the problem better and hence deal it better. Mr. Justice Taqdeer Ramdhani, Judge Supreme Court of Indonesia, spoke on the Indonesian Judicial Certificates Program on the environment, where only those judges who have environmental certifications are qualified to hear environmental cases. Justice Hassan Firoz Siddiqui, Judge Supreme Court of Bangladesh, spoke on the establishment of environmental court and need of environmental education at all level. Justice Tahir Ali Ansari, Supreme Court Judge of Nepal, spoke on the need of the environmental protection and law enforcement in fostering equitable, sustainable development. Justice retired Tanveer Ahmed Khan, Director General, Punjab Judiciary, spoke on the role of the Punjab Judicial Academy. He further highlighted the relationship between the environment and Islam. He said, first, and it is necessary to clean of inner environment pollution. He said that the change will come not on overnight. What we need is to adopt short-term and long-term plan in order to gradually find absolute about the issue. Justice Javed Jabbar, Vice President of IUCN, highlighted the importance of civil society organization, challenges faced by them in creation of the environmental awareness. He stressed the need of certain capacity building measures which are to be taken for public to make them aware about the issue. Umay Kramullah highlighted the judicial environmental capacity building role of the judges in environmental enforcement and role of the Judicial Academy. After deliberation, the House recommended that in order to create awareness amongst the people about the issue of environmental hazards and in order for them to cooperate on this issue, the people should be given an Islamic perspective on the environment, that judicial environment education should continue for all relevant stakeholders. Three, the environmental curriculum should be made part curriculum for the textbook of all tiers of education. Four, the training and trainer should be conducted for developing specialization and experts in different aspects of the environmental law. Five, the judges should be trained in environmental law in order to enable them to make judgment in accordance with the ideas of sustainable development. I am highly grateful to Mr. Anwar Jamali for inviting me in this conference. Thank you.